anyone, whether good or bad. So if we really acknowledge God as our Father, we should allow Him to direct us, to guide us, to make us, and to do everything that He wants to do for us. We should give God that opportunity to do everything He wants to do that, good or bad. And if we do so, we are supposed to surrender to God. Let God take charge of us. Let God control us. Let God do what He wants. Because if we don't give God this chance, it means we have never acknowledged God as our Father. We have never acknowledged God as our Creator. We have never acknowledged God or given God a chance to do what He wants with us. If we continue grumbling and complaining because we are going through a hard situation, if we continue complaining and questioning God, we are trying to show God that He's wrong. We are trying to show God that we have not given Him the right to guide us, to take us through good and evil time. We need to surrender to God. Let us give our Creator an opportunity to create us, to mold us in good situations and even in the bad situation, to punish us when we make a mistake and to control us. Today, let us go back to God for a checkup. Our message title is Going Back to God for a Checkup. God is our Creator. God is the one who made us. So God has got the right to control us, to make us, to change us, and to help us to be what He wants us to be. I was taught by a normal thing or something you might enjoy, a normal item that maybe we interact with daily, that is a car. Gary, when a car is taken to a shop, or when a car is manufactured and sold to a certain person, the car needs service. After a long period of time, the car needs to be taken back to the owner, the one who made the car, or a mechanic, so that the mechanic can check all parts. Because the best person to look at the car, the best person to bring or restore the car back to normal, is the best person who knows the best item to place in each and every corner, is the one who created the car, the one who made the car, the owner of the car, the one who made that car. The one who made the car knows the name of all the items, all the organs, knows the function of all the organs, knows the importance of all the organs, knows even the spare part that can be used to replace each and every organ if the organ is damaged. The person knows the importance of each and every organ. Then we should surrender your car to that person if you want it to be corrected, if you want it to be made, if you want it to be to go back to the normal way it used to function, or even to become new and better than the way it was before. You must surrender the car to the owner. Now the question comes, is the mechanic the one supposed to tell you when and where to take your car? Even if the mechanic knows that your car is damaged because of the way it is behaving, the mechanic is not supposed to tell you, or the mechanic cannot order you or force you that it is a must you bring your car to my garage. The mechanic does not have that authority. Yes, maybe the mechanic has it, but he cannot force you. If the mechanic cannot force you to take your car to the garage by force, but the mechanic can only advise you, I think your car has a problem. I think your car needs to be taken for a checkup. I think your car needs to be taken back to the owner so that it can be corrected. Because maybe in a toa moshi sana, maybe it has something. Inaonyesha kuna shida. And the mechanic can only advise you. It is your own responsibility. It is your own decision to make a decision, to make a responsibility. You make that decision. Now it is my time to take my car to the owner, to take my car to the garage. You are the one to make that decision. The decision to make, you are the one to make that decision. Nobody can make it to you. Then you also make the decision where to take your car. If you take your car to the wrong mechanic, then instead ya kutengenezwa, itaharibiwa. Instead ya kutengenezwa, itaharibiwa. Itakuwa mbaya kuliko hata mwenye ilikuwa. So you need to take your car to the right mechanic. that type of a car. So our best mechanic, the best mechanic that we can take our person, or the best person we can run to check us, is God. Because He's the one who created all parts of our body. He's the one who created all organs. The most important part of a car, yes, a car has so many organs and parts, but the most important part of a car is an engine. Engine, if a car does not have an engine, then it cannot function. Because that is the most important part. Today, the most important part of our body, the most important part of our body is our heart. If you don't have that heart, you cannot speak, you cannot function. In fact, you are dead without the heart. You are dead without the heart. That is the engine that we need. The engine is the heart. Today, we need to take our heart back to the Creator. We need to take our heart back to God. We need to take our heart back to God so that God can change it, so that God can replace it, so that God can search the heart and check every corner of the heart and remove any damage, anything that is unworthy in the heart, so that you can continue, or so that you can function properly. You can function and you can fulfill the reason why God created you. God created you so that you can glorify His name. God created you for His own glory. So we need to go back for a checkup. We need to go back for a checkup to our Maker, to our God, so that God can check our hearts. Proverbs 4:23. That is the word we are going to read today. Proverbs 4:23. The book of Proverbs 4:23. Let us go to our Maker. God created us. If our heart has a problem, then we are going to behave in a funny way.
Proverbs 4:23. Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life.
Above everything, guard your heart. Take care of your heart. Because if the way you speak is determined by the condition of your heart, the way you behave is determined by the condition of your heart, the way you walk is determined by the condition of your heart, the way you do everything you do in life is determined by the condition of your heart, the way a car behaves is determined by the engine. What is the condition of your heart this morning? The way you speak, it can show the condition of your heart. If you're speaking insulting things, then it means kuna shida. Na shida iko wapi? Iko kwa engine. Our heart. There is a problem. We need to go back for a checkup. You need to choose a day. You don't want to choose for yourself. Choose a day and go for a checkup. How do you go for a checkup? Through prayer. Pray. Dedicate yourself. Separate yourself. Take time. Go for a checkup. Start praying. Fasting, praying, or whichever means of prayer you're going to use. Start praying. Ask God. The Bible says that God is the only one who knows the heart of a man. The heart of a man is very hidden. Mimi siwezi jua roho yako. Na wewe hawezi jua roho yako. It is hidden. When God created us, alificha roho. And the one who created it is the only one who knows what is hidden in the heart. Jeremiah 17:10. God is the only one who knows what is hidden in your heart. Jeremiah 17:10.
I, the Lord, search the heart and examine the mind to reward a man according to his conduct, according to what his deeds deserve.
The Bible says in Jeremiah 17:10 that I, the Lord is the only one who can search my heart. My mother cannot search my heart. The Lord, when God was creating us, there are some parts are exposed, like macho, mapua, other parts are exposed. But there is one important part, the most important part in our body. God alificha. God ali make sure that alificha our hearts. Nobody That is why tunaonanga I can go to my friend and I can share my experience. You want me to na pitia shida na pitia hivi na hivi na hivi. Na niongeleshe mzuri sana na hiyo oi dada yangu ndugu yangu pole. Eh, unapitia nini? Pole. Mungu anakupenda, Mungu anakukumbuka. Eh, yani ni kama ni kabisa. Lakini nikipenduka kidogo nimuondoke. Nikimpatia mgongo, aanze kunionyesha na mgongo muone, muone.
Jeremiah 17:9. The heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can understand it?
We believe in Jeremiah 17:9 that roho yetu ni mdanganyifu. We have our type of heart. That means roho yetu inakuwa na mdanganyifu. When I just come to Ivana, hypocritical. But the only one who can see is God. Nobody can see what is here in your heart. That is why Jeremiah 17:10 says, it is only God that can search my heart. It is only God that can search your heart. It is only God that can know what is hidden in my heart and what is hidden in your heart. Because He is the one who made us. And it is only God that can wash away all the lying, all the deceitfulness inside our heart. It is only God that can change us. It is only God that can change me. That is one type of our heart. And the second type of our heart is a sick heart. And we have read it in Jeremiah 17:9. The Bible says that you have a deceitful heart and a sick heart. Roho zetu ni mgonjwa. Roho zetu imegonjeka. Ni nini ambacho inafanyaga roho igonjeke? Virus. Wakati uko mgonjwa, ni virus inakwanza imeingia ndani yako. Either a virus or a bacteria. Then the virus and the bacteria make you become sick. And it forms the sickness. Then from there, you start feeling, I am sick. I have a headache or any other kind of sickness. Dami ikiingia kwa roho yako, huwa inaleta ugonjwa. Huwa inaleta ugonjwa. Unakuwa mgonjwa. Uongo ikiingia ndani yako, inaleta ugonjwa. That I cannot survive without lying. Kwa sababu ugonjwa ile virus ya uongo imeingia ndani yangu. Ile virus ya majusi imeingia ndani yangu. Ile virus ya drug abuse imeingia ndani yangu. Now what do I need to do for me to be healed? It is only God who can heal you. It is only God who can give you a new heart. It is only God who can change your heart. It is only God who can create a pure heart in you and me. Let us have a prayer item. And I pray that this week as you move on, let this be our prayer in Psalms 51:10. Let this be our prayer this week. As you face the wind, the question is, there are four questions. One, what is the condition of your heart? Number two, then after realizing the condition of your heart, utapeleka roho yako apitengenezwe. Now question number three, who can create or make a pure heart in you? Question number four, who can change your heart? Another question, who is supposed to tell you when to take your heart? It is your own decision. You are supposed to decide for yourself. Psalms 51:10. Psalms 51:10. It is only you. It is only you that you can decide. Wewe ndio utajua nitapeleka roho yangu Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday na nitapeleka wapi. Ukitapeleka roho yako kwa shetani, ujue is the wrong mechanic. Ataharibu instead ya kutengeneza. Because the Bible says in John 10:10 that the evil one or a thief comes to steal, kill and destroy. Peleka shetani instead ya kukusaidia, ataua hiyo roho. Ataharibu zaidi, ataimaliza. Take it to the right mechanic. And the right mechanic is the one who created you. God is the one who created you. Hakuna mali tumeambia shetani alitucreate. God is the one hand you. So take your heart to the right mechanic and mwambie, today I surrender to you. Create a pure heart in me. Let this be our prayer as we face the week. In Psalms 51, verse 10.
Psalms 51, verse 10. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me.
Let us go to God as you face a new week, a new month. Surrender yourself to God. Kama mtu anaweza peleka gari yake kwa mekani, alafu usimwamini, then haiwezi kusaidia. Hawezi peleka gari yako kwa mekani, then ufunge vioo na milango zote na uende na ufunguo. Then you expect the mechanic to correct your car. Then you expect the mechanic to correct your car. It cannot happen. You need to surrender everything. You go there, you open all the doors, all the windows, umpatie ufunguo, ameshika hiyo ufunguo. Angalia kila mahali, angalia kila kona, angalia kila kitu, tengeneza gari yako. If you do so, atakusaidia. Na usiende kwa Mungu ukiwa na ukijionyesha, Mungu anajua, Mungu anakujua. Usiende mbele ya Mungu ukimwambia Mungu, shida yangu iko kwa macho, mwambie wewe angalia. Because unamwambia mekaniki wewe angalia. Kwa nini natoa moshi? Wewe angalia. Ukiona ni oil iko na shida, badilisha. Ukiona ni injini iko na shida, badilisha. Ukiona ni mwa kata kama ni tairi, badilisha. Take your surrender to God, ambia Mungu angalia. Search my heart, God. Search my heart, God. Remove everything hidden. Remove everything hidden in my heart. Change me. Create a pure heart, a new heart in me. So that God, in this new heart and pure heart, I can serve you. Psalms 21 verse 10. God, create a new heart in me. God is the only one who can create a new heart in you, me and you. Nobody can do that for you. Nobody can do that for you. Wana nimekuja mbele zako, unifanye jinsi wewe upendavyo. Wana nimekuja mbele zako, unifanye jinsi wewe upendavyo. Nifinyange, 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 unifanye jinsi wewe upendavyo. Na kubondeka mbele zako.
unto us. God bless.
Nduamada, cause of time, we may not proceed past that, we may not go beyond that, cause of time.